Hey there, welcome. It's Flo again. Today's practice is a short stretching routine you can do after your training. That means after the gym, after lifting weights, after CrossFit training, after jiu-jitsu, after whatever it is. I have not lifted weights in about 4 or 5 years, but even back then I did always a stretching routine in the end to finish up my training and to cool down before I took a shower and then left and had some food or something. It's really important after the training, no matter what training, that you take the time to cool down and slow down and stretch. Also, we will work on our breathing to increase this effect of slowing down, and what's happening is that you move into a more relaxed and restore state with your nervous system. You don't want to be in this active hyper state from bench pressing and from lifting weights and jiu-jitsu and martial arts and stay like hyper in your nervous system. You want to slow down. And so this is exactly what this class is doing. We'll keep it very short and on the point, but I highly recommend you stay and you join and you make this part of your routine. Like every time after training, do this class or do some kind of stretches and slow breathing as we will do today. We'll begin in a tabletop position, so just come onto all fours. And I hope you find a quiet corner in your home or in your gym or wherever you're doing this. And we'll stretch out the forearms. So bring the hands down to the ground, the fingertips are pointing towards the knees. Stay on the toes and then lean back. Let the palms lift up. We're stretching now the feet, the toes, the plantar fascia, the soles of our feet, as well as the forearms and the fingers. So for example, if you did lots of pulling or rowing or deadlifts or climbing, this one is very nice after those activities. Stretch out the forearms, fingers, toes. You can bend one arm and the other. Very good. Stay on the toes, sit on the heels, shake out the hands. Get the blood flow going again. And interlace your hands just to finish up the wrists and the hands here. Roll in a circle with your hands. It's so important to take care of the wrists in general. And especially if you do heavy lifting, switch directions. For a lot of people, the fingers, the wrists, the forearms suffer a lot because we don't focus on them much. But they're actually involved in all the activities because you have to grip. Let's come down onto the forearms. Lower the hips down, untuck the toes, bring the feet wide apart. We want to keep the shoulders roughly above the elbows for a gentle back bend. A lot of our activities and trainings is doing exactly the opposite. So we're rounding the back, we're tightening the core, we're creating lots of compression here and lots of flexion in the spine. And by countering that, you just get more into a state of homeostasis where everything is in balance. If you want more, straighten the arms. Maybe just halfway, maybe fully. If that's too much, bring your forearms back down. Now notice your breathing, slow the breath down. The breathing directly affects your nervous system, and so by breathing slow or slower, you move faster and more efficiently into this relaxed state of your nervous system that I talked about earlier. So as we're doing these poses, these stretches, focus on the breath and slow the breath down. Let's release. This one I like to call wrestler's twist because we do it a lot in martial arts. You bring the right arm all the way out to the side. If you want more, you can also bend the arm and keep it at 90 degrees. This is a nice one for the shoulders, the chest, also the arms to stretch. I will do the version with the straight arm. Then you bend your left leg and bring that left foot all the way over to the right side of your right leg. You can stay here on your fingertips with the left hand. So you're twisting, you're also back bending, you're also stretching the pecs, the shoulders. You can relax the head down, slow the breath down. And usually if you're in the gym right now, then you can just find a quiet corner. Usually they have corners and areas for functional training with kettlebells and those big balls to use, and you can find some area hopefully where you can do this. Very, very important to integrate after your training. So even if people are looking or looking at you while you're doing all of this, it's all good. You will be the one that's pain-free for the years to come. And maybe they are, unfortunately, the ones that will end up in pain and have back pain and all of it because they're not balancing the body and they're not balancing all this hard training. Release, come back to the belly. If you feel ready, let's do the other side. Left arm out. Bring the right foot up and over. Relax the head down, breathe. And return to the belly. A lot of us have really tight quads, so that's why we're focusing a little bit on the quads now as well. Keep the left forearm on the ground, kind of like 45 degrees, and then bend your right leg, and with your right hand you reach for that foot. The fingers, your fingers, can point towards the towards your right knee, and then you push down. Or if you don't feel much here and you want to go a little bit deeper, you can rotate your hand so that the fingers are pointing up towards your head. Just for about 10 more seconds here, we're pushing down, so we're lengthening the quad. It's a very big muscle, and because for a lot of us it's so tight, we get some knee problems. So by lengthening it, we just keep the knees and the muscle itself, the quads, healthier. Slowly release. Other side, right forearm down, kind of like 45 degrees, bend the left leg, grab it, either with the fingertips pointing towards your left knee or upwards towards the head. Slow the breath down. And release, nice and slow. Let's come up to a seated position so you can slowly push back. I will rotate on my mat. We bring the legs wide apart for a seated straddle forward fold. So you come into a wide straddle position. And you walk then the hands forward. Take your time to ease into it. We are just looking for a nice sensation in the body, maybe in the inner legs, the inner thighs, groin area, maybe also your lower back. And some days you feel more open here, some days you feel tighter. Depends what you did the last days and how much you were sitting, and maybe you trained really hard, so it's a little bit more tight. It's all good. Every day is different also for me. Today I feel more tight in my lower back because I already filmed a lot today, some very hard classes. So if you're new to the channel and you were wondering if we also offer something else here besides stretching like this, this is only stretching. Yes, we have a lot of very hard bodyweight classes on our channel, lots of breathing exercises, lots of meditation, if you want to check it out. Let's stay for about 20 more seconds. Slow the breath down. Walk the hands back. And we're coming into a side bend. So now we're lengthening the side body and also the lats and the arm lines. You can bring the right forearm inside the right leg, and then you simply reach with your left arm up and over the head towards the right foot. Don't struggle to like, oh, I want to reach. Doesn't matter. Just reach over. If you feel it in the left side upper body, it's all good. No need to touch and grab the foot. But if it's there, then grab it. Focus more on the breath. Feel the sensation. And back through center. Let's switch sides. Left forearm inside the left leg. And reach the right arm up and over the head towards the left foot. Rotate your chest a bit more to the right. Just so that you're not closing the chest down towards the ground. Try to keep it open. So it's a true side bend. On the inhale, release. Come back up. Very good. Bring the legs together. I will rotate on my mat. Second to last pose. We're almost done here. Straighten the legs forward. And then we're folding forward and down. First, I recommend from here, before you go into this, to bend the legs. Grab the feet. And then you start to scoot the hips back. Until you feel a stretch in the back side of your leg. Especially the hamstrings, maybe the calves, maybe the lower back. And that's where you stay. So if it looks like this for you and you feel it here already, stay there. It's all good. For me, I've been doing this for many years. Every day I don't feel anything here, so I need to straighten my legs more. Now I feel it too, and here I stay. So we're all doing the same, but it looks different because our bodies are different. Let's do about 15 or so seconds here. So three nice slow breaths. And release. Walk the hands back. Push yourself back up. And come to a seated position. Cross your legs. I will rotate again so you can see me better, but stay wherever you are. Cross your legs, sit down, sit tall, close your eyes just for a minute to do a final cool down, to be thankful for your body today that you could do all this training that you did. Thank yourself for doing your best, for showing up, for investing in yourself. Let's take a deep breath in through the nose. Open mouth, let it go. Take two more just like that to finish up. Blink your eyes open. Thank you very much for joining me today. Have a wonderful day. If you feel good in your body now, if you like this video, please subscribe and like. And I'll see you in the next one tomorrow. Have a great day.